from Surah Yunus to this Surah Al-Anbiya. These are 12 surahs and subdivided into 4 subgroups of 3 surahs. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Yusuf, one subgroup. Surah Ra'd, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Hijr, second subgroup. Surah Al-Nahl, Surah Bani Israel, Surah Al-Kahf, third group. Surah Maryam, Surah Taha, Surah Al-Anbiya, fourth group. Now we come to Surah Al-Anbiya. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. This is nearly the same ayah which appears in the beginning of Surah Al-Nahl. أتى أمر الله فلا تستعجلوه. Allah's command is just at your doorsteps. Now don't hasten for it. اقترب للناس حسابهم. The reckoning for the people has come very near to them. And they are in their heedlessness. They are turning away, averse to it. مَا يَعْتِهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ مُحْدَسٍ. Whenever a new admonition comes to them from their Lord, إِلَّا اسْتَمَعُوهُ, they listen to it. وَهُمْ يَلَعْبُونَ, but they are playing. They don't pay attention. They don't ponder over it. Just playing, you know. هُمْ يَلَعْبُونَ لَاهِيَةً قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their hearts are busy in jokes. وَاسْرُ النَّجْوَى. And then they consult each other secretly. Alladina zalamu, these people who are evil doers. Hal haza illa basharu mislukum. This person, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is nothing but a mortal human being like you. Afatatuna sihr. So do you want to follow magic and sorcery? Vantum tusirun, and you are seeing it. You know, it is just as if a few friends were there. They were discussing. Someone might have said, well, we should pay attention to what Muhammad says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At least we should listen to him, ponder over it. Maybe something is good which he is saying. So the others would say this, hal haza illa basharu mislukum. Why do you want to listen to him? He is nothing but a mortal human being like us. Afatatuna same. Yes, he has some sorcery, some magic he knows. So do you want to follow and go near this sorcery? Vantum tumsirun. And you are seeing with your eyes. قَالَ رَبِّي يَعْلَمُ الْقَوْلَ فِي السَّمَاءِ. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my Lord knows all the words which are spoken in the whole of the sky or heaven and the earth. وَهُوَ أَبْوَهُوَ السَّمِيُّ الْعَلِيمُ. He's all-hearing, all-knowing. بَلْ قَالُوا أَزْغَاسُ أَحْلَامُ. Now they were presenting different opinions. What is this wahi that Muhammad is presenting? So one opinion was given, بَلْ قَالُوا أَزْغَاسُ أَحْلَامٍ. These are but mixed up dreams and nothing else. Mixed up dreams. أَزْغَاسُ أَحْلَامٍ. بَلْ افْتَرَاهُ. Others said, no, he is forging it himself. He is composing it himself. بَلْ هُوَ شَاعِرٌ. A third opinion came, no, he is a poet. فَلْيَاتِنَا بِآيَةٍ كَمَا أُرْسِلَ الْأَوَّلُونَ. So he should bring forth some sign, just as the former messengers were sent with signs. When he himself says, such big signs were given to Jesus, Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. You know, saying to a dead person, Qum, and he stands up, he is alive. A blind person, and he gets his vision. All these, you know, things, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam showed these miracles. Hazrat Musa alayhi salam showed, and we have read in Surah Bani Israel, 9 tis'a ayatin bayyinatin. 9 miracles. So they said, فَلْيَاتِنَا بِآيَةٍ كَمَا أُرْسِلَ الْأَوَّلُونَ. If he claims to be a messenger, he should bring forth some miracles. مَا آمَنَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا أَفَهُمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Now this is the reply from Allah. Formerly also when the miracles were shown, did people come to believe? Did the Jews believe in Isa alayhi salam? Although they had seen all the miracles. Did Firaun and his people believe in Musa alayhi salam? Although they saw 9 miracles. Did Samud believe in Saleh alayhi salam? Although on their demand, a pregnant she camel came out from a rock. But they didn't believe. They said, this is sihr and this is sorcery. Only, you know, our sight has been possessed somehow and we are seeing something which is not actually there. So, afa ma amanat qablahum min qaryatin. No township came to believe due to these miracles. Ahlaknaha, and we destroyed them all. Afahum yuminun. So, will they come to believe if miracles are shown? The Quraysh will come to believe. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا قَبْلَكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ. And before you also, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we didn't send as messengers but men. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الزِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. So you must ask people, oh you people, you ask people who have the admonition, have the scriptures, have the books, Torah and Injil. Go and ask them. Every time, all the time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been sending human beings as messengers. وَمَا جَعَلْنَاهُمْ جَسَدًا لَا يَعْكُلُونَ الطَّعَامِ. And we never gave to any messenger of Allah a body which didn't need any food. They needed food, just like all human beings need food. وَمَا كَانُوا خَالِدِينَ. They were not immortals. They were not to live forever. ثُمَّ صَدَقْنَاهُمُ الْوَعْدَ. But then in the end, we fulfilled to them the promise. We had promised them, we shall save you and we shall destroy your enemies. This was the enemy of this was the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all the messengers. You show perseverance, you go on calling. Your duty is وَمَا عَلَيْكُمْ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ. Go on doing it. Now we shall take care of them and we shall save you and those people who believe in you, and we shall destroy your enemies. Just like the people of Nuh and people of Hud and people of Saleh and so on and so forth. ثُمَّ صَدَقْنَاهُمُ الْوَعْدَ فَانْجَيْنَاهُمْ. We delivered them and saved them. And we fulfilled our promise which we had made to them. مَنْ نَشَاءُ وَأَهْلَقْنَا الْمُسْرِفِينَ. And we destroyed the prodigals. لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرُكُمْ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. O people, we have sent down for you this book in which there is admonition for you. There is remembering for you, reminding for you, guidance for you. So don't you understand and don't you ponder over it? وَكَمْ قَسَمْنَا مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ كَانَ ظَالِمَةً وَانْشَانَا بَعْدَهَا قَوْمًا آخَرِينَ. And how many a township did we shatter and pound who were evil doing? وَانْشَانَا, and we raised after them another people, another nation. فَلَمَّا أَحَسُّوا بَعْسَنَا إِذَا هُمْ مِنْهَا يَرْكُزُونَ. But when they felt that our chastisement is coming, is near, then they started running away, fleeing. لَا تَرْكُزُوا. Now don't run, there's no use of running away. وَرْجَوْا إِلَى مَا أُتْرِفْتُمْ فِيهِ. Go to your houses and buildings and mansions and villas in which, you know, you have been given all the luxuries or all the amenities. وَمَسَاكِنَكُمْ. And go to your dwellings. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُسْأَلُونَ. Maybe that somebody there takes care of you. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. They said, woe to us. Actually, we were the evildoers. فَمَا زَالَتْ تِلْكَ دَعْوَاهُمْ. They kept on saying this. We were the evildoers. We wronged ourselves. We were on the wrong path. فَمَا زَالَتْ تِلْكَ دَعْوَاهُمْ. They repeatedly kept saying this. حَتَّى جَعَلْنَاهُمْ حَسِيدًا خَامِدِينَ. Till that time we made them a harvest which has been reaped and extinct. وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاءَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا لَاعِبِينَ. O mankind, we have not created the heaven and the earth and what is in between the two as a joke or as a play. لَوْ أَرَدْنَا أَن نَتَّخِذَ لَهْوًا. Had we decided to have some pastime for us, لَتَّخَذْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا. We certainly would have taken it with ourselves. إِن كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. If ever we were to do it. Why to create this universe only for playing? You know, in Hindus, they say, this is Ram ki Leela. Ram is playing. Just as a small boy, he lifts a toy and then throws it. Then again lifts another one, throws it. In this way, Ram, he raises somebody high and then throws him down. And at another time, he raises somebody else high and throws him down. This is Ram ki leela. This is the game that Ram is playing. لَوَرَدْنَا نَتَّخَذْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا إِنْ كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ بَلْ نَقْذِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَعُهُ فَإِذَا هُوَ زَاهِقٌ. This is very important ayah. The strife between haq and batil. It has been going on, going on, going on from day one to today. And it will continue till the last day. As Iqbal says, ستیزہ کار رہا ہے ازل سے تا امروز چراغ مصطفی بھی سے شرار بولہ بھی. There has been, you know, a confrontation between the light of Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. Well, actually, whatever all the messengers were given, this was light. We can say it metaphorically, it was light of Muhammad. And Bulahab, the uncle, the disbeliever, the enemy, Sharar Bulahab. So light of Muhammad and this, you know, from Sharar of Bulahab, they have been fighting each other from day one and will continue till the last day. But Allah says here, بَلْ نَقْزِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِرِ. We strike falsehood with truth. We take the truth and strike falsehood with it. فَيَدْمَغُهُ. So it knocks out its brains. And behold, it vanishes. Batil goes away. لَكُمْ وَلَكُمُ الْوَيْلُ مِمَّا تَصِفُونَ. And woe to you for what you describe. This batil will go. We have read in Surah Bani Israel, جَا الْحَقُّ وَذَحَقُ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. So this confrontation between Haqq and Batil will continue till the final victory of Haqq, Al-Haqq, about which the Prophet had said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that before the end of this world, Deen of Allah, or we may call it Nizamu Khilafat ala Manhajin Nabuwa, that will dominate the whole of the globe. A time is going to come. Although before that, a time of very severe chastisement is coming for the Muslim Ummah. What's going to flare up into a war in the Middle East? To our Arab brethren, it's going to be a very big, very big, very big destruction. And maybe the same happens to Pakistan also. Because if there is some atomic confrontation in the Middle East, what I feel is that these Western powers will first of all knock out the atomic capability of Pakistan, lest it should come into the field. Anyhow, we have to pray to Allah. So it has to go away. Batil will be finished. Final victory is going to be for the truth. All the Jews will be exterminated. Christianity as a religion will come to an end. When Jesus comes for the second time, he will say, I was not crucified. What have you invented? And I never declared that pig can be eaten. يَكْسَرُ السَّلِيمُ وَيَقْتُلُ الْخِنْزِيرُ. So this Christianity will vanish. All will be Muslims. The Muslim Ummah. And then there will be the rule of the Deen of Haq. وَلَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَنْ عِنْدَهُ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنِ عِبَادَتِهِ وَلَا يَسْتَحْسِرُونَ. And to him, that is Allah, belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَمَنْ إِنْدَهُ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. And those who are with him, who are those? Nearer to him, who are those? They are the malaika. الْمَلَائِكَةُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. Malaika have different levels. You know, the angels of this world, the angels in the first heaven, the angels in the second, then the malaikatu al-muqarrabun, then the hamalatul arsh, those angels who are holding the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they are different levels. وَالَّذِينَ مَنْ إِنْدَهُ. Who are with him, near him. لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنِ عِبَادَتِهِ. They are not arrogant to refuse to obey Allah's commands and worship him. وَلَا يَسْتَحْسِرُونَ. And they never get tired in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُسَبِّحُونَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ وَلَا يَفْتَرُونَ. They keep on glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by day and night. And they slacken not. They don't slacken in it. أَمِتَّخَذُوا عَلِيَةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ هُمْ يُنْسِرُونَ. Have they adopted some gods in this earth. You know, there are gods. They say gods who are controlling this earth, gods who are controlling the air, the winds, gods who are controlling the fire, gods there who are controlling these stars, etc., etc. Thousands and thousands of gods and goddesses. So have they taken up gods from the earth? Who raised the dead? Whom you shall, will they be able to raise the dead from their graves? لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا عَلَيْهَةٌ. Had there been in the earth and the heavens gods and goddesses, إِلَّا اللَّهِ, except Allah, لَفَسَدَتَا, they both would go to ruin, will be destroyed. You know, one mind, one mashiya, one scheme of thing, one wisdom of Allah is controlling the whole universe. If there are others also, then there will be difference of opinion. And you know, there will be fasad. This whole universe will go to ruin. Subhanallah Rabbil Arsh Amma Yasifoon. Glory is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Lord of the throne. And he is pure from what they describe. La yus'alu amma yaf'alu wa hum yus'alun. He is not questioned about what he does. Nobody can question him. Nobody is over him. He is not responsible to anybody. He has the all authority in his own hands. La yus'al amma yaf'al. He is not questioned. He cannot be questioned on what he does. Wa hum yus'alun. All the others will be questioned. Even the messengers of Allah will be questioned. We read ayah number 6 in Surah Al-A'raf. فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. We shall question those also to whom we sent our messengers. And we shall question the messengers also. We sent you our message for your nation. Did you deliver the message? Did you convey? The messengers will have to testify. Stand and testify. Oh Allah, yes. The message from you which came to us, we had delivered to them. We had conveyed to them. Now they are responsible. They are accountable. So everybody is going to be questioned except Allah. Nobody can question him. La yusalu amma yafalu wa hum yusalun. Amit tahadu min dunihi aliha. Have they taken besides Allah other gods? Ul hatu burhanakum. So say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bring forth your argument. Do you have any argument for any other God beside Allah? Whether in your intellect, your understanding, is there any basis? Whether any scripture which might have been revealed, it contains something that there is such and such God and Goddess with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Hatu burhanakum. Haza zikru man ma'iya. This Quran is the admonition for me and those who are with me. وَذِكْرُ مَنْ قَبْلِي. And here are mentioned those also who are before me. Nuh has been mentioned, Hud has been mentioned, Saleh has been mentioned, Ibrahim has been mentioned, Ismail has been mentioned, Ishaq and Yaqub and Musa and Yusuf, all have been mentioned. بَلْ أَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْحَقَّ فَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. But most of them don't know, can't recognize the truth. And that is why they are turning away. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. And we didn't send before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a single messenger. But we have been revealing to them, أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا, that there is no God except me. فَعْبُدُونَ. So worship me. Now this ibadah has two sides. Worship and obedience. Abd in Arabic means slave. What's the duty of the slave? To obey the master. So abd, and from this is ibadah. We have to obey Allah in all our life, all aspects. Every, you know, an employee-employer relationship is different. You can say, you employed me as a driver, as a chauffeur. You can't say to me that go and you know, clean my toilet. No, that's not my job. I was employed For example, as a cook, you can't ask me to go and clean the toilet. But a slave cannot say it. He has to do whatever is commanded to. And then there's no times. He's a slave 24 hours. At any night time, day time, at any time, whatever command the Lord, the, you know, Aqa, the master gives, he has to. So in this way, total obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the center of ibadah. But this ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be with extreme love for him. And to show him our humility, we bow before him, we stand before him in qunut, we prostrate before him. These are ibadat. We are fasting according to his command. These are ibadat. But what is ibadah? Ibadah is total obedience and worshipping. So, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدُونَ. And we didn't send before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a single messenger, but to all we sent the revelation that there is no God except me. So worship me, obey me. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا. And they say that Rahman, the compassionate one, he has taken some son or daughter, some offspring for him. Subhanah. He is pure from all these things. Glorified be he. Bal ibadum mukramun. You are calling them to be daughters of Allah, malaika. They are bondsmen of Allah, creations of Allah, bondsmen to Allah, but they are respected. Malaikatun, they are ibadun mukramun, honored. They are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially al-malaikatul mukarrabun. You know, they are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is something else, honored. But they are ibad. They are slaves. They are bondsmen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يسبقونه بالقول. They never precede him in word. They always wait to listen what Allah says. They never start something from their side. You know, it's against the etiquettes, you know, that they should say something to Allah. They keep waiting to listen to what Allah says. لا يسبقونه بالقول. They don't begin with anything to say to him. وَهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِ يَعْمَلُونَ. And they keep on executing the command of Allah. His commands, they keep on executing. And they work for that. يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ. He knows whatever is in front of them and whatever is behind them. وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى. And they will not intercede except for those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes. وَهُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَتِهِ مُشْفِقُونَ. And they will be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there will be awe in them. وَمَنْ يَقُلْ مِنْهُمْ إِنِّي إِلَٰهٌ مِنْ دُونِهِ. And supposedly, perchance, if someone amongst them says, I am a God beside Allah. وَمَنْ يَقُلْ مِنْهُمْ. And whosoever from among them says that I am a God beside Allah, فَالظَّالِكَ نَجْزِيهِ جَهَنَّمْ. So he will be rewarded with the hell. كَذَالِكَ نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ. In this way we reward the evildoers. أَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتَقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا. Have not those who disbelieve seen that the heavens and the earth, they were closed up, and then we separated them, or we opened them. Now the meaning of this ayah up till this time was that it refers to, you know, when the rain is not coming, there is drought, as if, you know, the skies and heavens, they are also stopped, and the earth is stopped. Water is not coming. كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then induces the rain to come down. But now a scientific phenomenon is being explained under this, that in the beginning of the creation, the heavens and earth, they were all one mass. One mass. one mass of matter. But then they were separated into heavens, into galaxies, into stars. Otherwise, in the very beginning, after the Big Bang, there was one mass, undifferentiated. There was no differentiation between them, that this thing will go to become a sun, and this will go to become a star, and this will go to make a moon, and this will go to make an earth. No, nothing of the sort. But then we separated them, and we made them into these forms. Wallahu alam. أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا. We opened them and separated them. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we made everything living, every living creature from water. What does it mean? We were made out of clay. But the life in us is from water. Basis of life. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we have made from water everything which is living. The basis of life is water. But the basis constitution of our body is from the clay, from the earth, from the mud. صَلْصَالٍ مِنْ حَمَئٍ مَسْنُونٍ. Thrice these words repeated in Surah Al-Hijr. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. أَفَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So are they not going to believe? وَجَعَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ رَوَاسِيَ أَن تَمِيدَ بِهِمْ. And we have fixed mountains on the earth so that it should not shake with them. وَجَعَلْنَا فِيهَا فِجَاجًا سُبُلًا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. And we have put and made in the earth very deep ravines and valleys so that they can traverse them. You know, you can't go on the tops of the mountains. You have to travel in the valleys. So they can traverse them. وَجَعَلْنَا سَمَاءَ سَقْفًا مَحْفُوظًا. And we have created this heaven as a very strong roof, well protected. وَهُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهَا مُورِدُونَ. And they turn away from the signs of these samawat. وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ. And it is He who created the night and the day and the sun and the moon. كُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. Everyone, each one of them, is floating in an orbit. This ayah is also very profound. You know, at different times during the development of science, different opinions were presented. First of all, we thought that the earth is stationary, the sun moves. We see it moving. It is moving from east to west. Earth is stationary. Then there came a time when it was reversed. Sun is stationary, earth is moving. But sun is stationary. But now we know everything is moving. Nothing is stationary in this universe. As Iqbal says, سُكُو مُحَال هَا قُدْرَتْ كَ كَارْخَانَ مَنْ. Nobody can stay. Everything is moving. Even in an atom structure, electrons, you know, in continuous movement. So actually, كُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَرُ. This kull, as it, you know, denotes today, the scientific, what we have known now, this word now is emphasized. كُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. Each floating in its orbit. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we didn't make before you any person immortal, ever living. أَفَيْ مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. So if you die, are they going to live forever? Your enemies will also die. Abu Jahl is not going to live forever. Abu Lahab is not going to live forever. If they say you are immortal, how can we accept you as a messenger of Allah? So all are mortals. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ أَفَإِن مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul has to taste death. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ. And we keep on testing you, trying you with something good, with something unpleasant. Sometimes we bestow upon you our mercy, our bounty, so you are pleased. Sometimes some harm comes to you, This also comes from us, by our command, by our permission. So we are testing you this way also, that way also. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And then you will be returned to us. وَإِذَا رَآكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَّخِذُونَكَ إِلَّا هُزُوًا. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when these disbelievers see you, they mock at you. أَحَذَا الَّذِي يَذْكُرُوا آلِهَتَكُمْ. Is he the person who mentions your gods, who says there is no god except Allah? This is the person. So pointing towards Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a disgraceful manner, أَحَذَا الَّذِي يَذْكُرُوا آلِهَتَكُمْ. He is the person who mentions your gods that they are false, they have no reality. وَهُمْ بِذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِهُمْ كَافِرُونَ. And about the mention of Rahman, the compassionate Allah, when about them, they deny, they reject. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلْ. Man has been created out of haste. Creation of man has two aspects. This our animal aspect, it has weaknesses. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Man has been created weak. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلْ. Hastiness is there in the nature of man, we may call. The spiritual aspect of our existence, it's very high. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. That is the spirit. ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. But that spirit was then joined to my body. And I am from أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. I am from this clay. This body has come from clay. But the spirit, it has come from the command of Allah. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلْ سَوْرِيكُمْ آيَاتِي فَلَا تَسْتَعْجَلُونَ. Soon I will show you my signs, so don't make haste. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. They say, are saying, when will this promise come to pass? When this Qiyamah will come? When will be this doomsday? If you are truthful, tell us. لَوْ يَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Only if these disbelievers could know, heena la yakuffuna an wujuhihim min nar, when they will not be able to ward off the fire from their faces, wala an zuhurihim, nor from their backs, wala hum yunsaroon, and there will be none to help them. They will not be helped. Bal taatihim baghtatan, but this will come to them suddenly. Fatamhatuhum, and then it will confound them. Fala yastati'una raddaha wala hum yunzaroon, then they will not be able to turn it back, nor they will be given any respite. وَلَقَدْ اِسْتَوْزِيَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. And O Muhammad, before you also, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so many of our messengers were mocked at. وَلَقَدْ اِسْتَوْزِيَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَحَاقَ بِالَّذِينَ سَخِرُوا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. But those that scoffed at them were encompassed by that, they mocked at. They were laughing, oh, chastisement will come. Oh, what will happen to these mountains? Oh, what do you say? We will be resurrected. But then all these things came before them. قُلْ مَنْ يَكْلَوْكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Ask them, who is guarding you during the night and the day? We are always in danger. When you are driving, you know, you are in danger. At any time, accident can take place. And at many times you feel that you have just escaped. Something, you know, was going to come. As if somebody had, you know, with his own hand, invisible hand, he just puts you aside and you are saved. So there are the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who protect you. They are the guards, they are the bodyguards that we have from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because a time has been fixed for my death. I cannot die before that. The angels have to see that I don't die. Kafabil mote hafiza. Mote is the, death is the best guard for a man. Because the time of death is fixed. And death cannot come before that. So as if Allah is guarding us. Till that time Allah will guard. And Allah guards through his angels. Qul man yaklaukum min layli wan nahar. Who guards you with the command Minar Rahman, due to the command of Allah, due to the daytime and night time, Balhum an zikr rabbihim muridun. But with the mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their Lord, they turn away. Am lahum alihatun tamna'uhum min dunina? Do they have gods who save them without us? La yastati'una nasra anfusihim. They don't have any power to help themselves. Walahum minna yushabun. Nor they will be defended from us. Bal mattana haulai wa ba'uhum. The real thing is that we provided comforts to them also and to their forefathers also. Hatta ta'ala alayhim al-umr. Till that time, life grew too long for them. Afala yarawna anna nati al-arda nanqusuha min atrafiha. Afahum al-ghalibun. Don't they see that we are coming towards them, diminishing the earth from its sides? Will they be able to prevail? This ayah is difficult to understand, but it has historical background. You know, Quraysh were in Mecca, but their zone of influence was spread far and wide. All the tribes, they seemed to be under Quraysh. They took Quraysh to be their leaders, if not rulers, leaders. So now what was happening? Now this tribe, some people among this tribe have become mu'min. Some people here in the other tribe, they have accepted iman. Now Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is coming from Medina, you know, and making a treaty with this tribe. Now making a treaty, concluded treaty with this tribe. So as Islam was spreading around Makkah, and when after Hijrah, you know, the zone of political influence of Muhammad was increasing, naturally the zone of political influence of Quraysh was decreasing and diminishing. As if Islam is advancing towards you from all the sides, and you are in Mecca, so actually Islam is advancing. We are diminishing, decreasing this land of your influence from all sides. So can they prevail? No, the truth will prevail. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أُنزِلَكُمْ بِالْوَحِيِّ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am warning you with the revelations which are coming to me. وَلَا يَسْمَعُ السُّمُّ الدُّعَاءِ إِذَا مَا يُنزَرُونَ. But those who are deaf, they don't hear my call. Then they are being warned. They are deaf actually. These ears are not deaf, they are listening. But their hearts have become deaf. These eyes are not blind, but their hearts have become blind. فَإِنَّا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ وَلَئِنْ مَسَّتْهُمْ نَفْحَةٌ مِّنَ الْعَذَابِ رَبِّكَ. And if a breath of your Lord's chastisement touches them, لَيَقُولُنَّ يَا وَيْلَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. Even a breath if touches them, they will say and cry out, woe to us! Actually, we were the evildoers. We were on the wrong path. We have ourselves invited this wrath of Allah on us. وَنَزَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And then we shall set up the scales of justice for the day of judgment. فَلَا تُزْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيَّا. No soul will be wronged even a bit. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ. Although it might have been their deeds, good or bad, might have been equal to the grain of a mustard seed, but everything will be counted and weighed. Atena biha, we shall bring all their deeds, howsoever small they might be. Wa kafa bina hasibin, and we are sufficient for reckoning. We can calculate them for them, whatever is due to them. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ الْفُرْقَانَ وَزَيَانَ وَذِكْرًا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And we gave Musa and Harun al-Furqan, the thing with which you can differentiate what is good, what is bad, what is right, what is wrong. وَزَيَانَ and light. وَذِكْرًا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ and admonition for the God-fearing. الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ, who keep fearing their Lord in the unseen. وَهُمْ مِنَ السَّاعَةِ مُشْفِقُونَ. And they are always trembling at the idea of السَّاعَةِ الْقِيَامَةِ, that hour and that doomsday and that day of judgment. وَهَذَا ذِكْرٌ مُبَارَكٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ. And now this is the admonition, very blessed admonition, which we have sent to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَفَأَنْتُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ. So are you going to refute it or accept it? بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم. We shall be beginning today with the fifth section of Surah Al-Anbiya. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد آتينا إبراهيم رشده من قبل وكنا به عالمين إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما هذه التماثيل التي أنتم لها عاكفون قالوا وجدنا آباءنا لها عابدين قال لقد كنتم أنتم وآباؤكم في ضلال مبين قالوا وجئتنا بالحق أم أنت من اللاعبين صدق الله العظيم. In the next two sections of this Surah Anbiya we have a mention of so many prophets and also some of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been having a list of the names of some of the prophets. We first of all had, and I said that it is a flower pot of the names of the prophets of Allah in Surah An-Nisa, again at one position in Surah Al-Imran, but here it is going to be a bit in detail. But please be acquainted with two terms of Quran. Just as I have told you, that in order to awaken and activate within the human being the dormant consciousness about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran either refers to the signs and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tazkir bi-Ala Illah, or refers to the historical events, big days, when, you know, the big chastisement came to the nations to whom the messengers were sent. And that is called At-Tazkir bi-Ayyamillah. In the same way, there are two terms regarding the accounts of the prophets and rusul and messengers of Allah in Quran. One is Amba'ur Rusul. Amba is the plural of Naba. Naba is, means a very important news, very big news. Amma yatasalun an an-naba'il 'azim alladhi hum fihi mukhtalifun. So Amba'ur Rusul, under this heading we have the account of those messengers of Allah whose nations were destroyed totally. I have named several times, to begin with Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, then Hazrat Hud, Hazrat Saleh, Hazrat Lut, Hazrat Shuaib, Hazrat Musa. These six, their accounts are similar. They came to their nations, they called them to worship none except Allah and accept them as messengers of Allah. The nations as a whole rejected, and then as a punishment they were devastated, annihilated. But there is another account of the prophets. You know, their personal virtues, their high moral character, their perseverance, for example. So all these things, but not that they came and they demanded that obey me and have faith in me, and if you don't believe me, you will have chastisement. Not in that way. The most glaring example was in Surah Yusuf. In full 13 sections of that surah, the story of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam has been told in detail. But nowhere that matter comes, that if the nation did not accept him, but neither the king of Egypt accepted him as a prophet, nor the nation as a whole of Egypt adopted him. So, but they were not devastated, annihilated, because he never claimed that I am messenger of Allah. So to be a prophet of Allah is something else, and to be a messenger of Allah is something else. So here you will find, you know, the mention of some of the prophets and the messengers also. Every messenger is definitely and necessarily a prophet also. Every prophet is not a messenger. But every messenger has to be a prophet first, And then actually he is selected, and then he is assigned a job to a particular place or to a particular people. So here we find, you know, the mention and this account and some of the prophets and messengers of Allah, but not in the form of Ambaul Rusul, but in the way of Qasatun Nabiyyin. These are the stories of the prophets. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ. And we had given Ibrahim min qabl. Before all these, we had given Ibrahim his guidance. وَكُنَّا بِهِ عَالَمِينَ. And we knew him absolutely. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ. Now we have this mention, what Hazrat Ibrahim said to his father in Surah Maryam also. Here it is in a second, in a different way. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ. Just recall when he said to his father and his nation, his people, مَا هَذِهِ التَّمَاثِيلُ الَّتِي أَنْتُمْ لَهَا عَاكِفُونَ. What are these images, these idols, to which you are devoted? You sit concentrating your attention on them. قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا لَهَا عَابِدِينَ. They said, we found our forefathers doing like this, worshipping them. So we are following them. We don't know why. What's the basis? What's the rationale? We don't know. But we found our forefathers doing like this, worshipping them. So we are following them. قَالَ لَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Now in very strong words, Ibrahim declared, no, not only you, but also your forefathers, they were in manifest error. They were wrong. Their way and path that they had taken was wrong. قَالُوا أَجَيْتَنَا بِالْحَقِّ أَمْأَنْتَ مِنَ اللَّاعِبِينَ. Now they asked him, have you brought some absolute truth to us, or you are just joking? Maybe a young man is just joking. No, are you serious? أَجَيْتَنَا بِالْحَقِّ. Have you brought to us some absolute truth, or you are just joking? قَالَ بَلْ رَبُّكُمْ. He said, no, it's no joke. Your Lord is رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the Lord of all the heavens and earth. الَّذِي فَتَرَهُنَّ. Who created them. He is the Lord of the heavens and earth, and He is the creator of the heavens and the earth. وَأَنَا عَلَىٰ ذَلِكُمْ مُنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. And I bear a testimony to this before you, that I don't believe in any God except the Lord of the heavens and the earth, who is also the creator of the heavens and the earth. وَتَاللَّهِ لَأَكِيدَنَّ أَصْنَامَكُمْ بَعْدَ أَن تُوَلُّوا مُدْبِرِينَ. And by God, I'll devise a plot against your idols when you go out turning your backs. There was going to be some big worship in the open field. Just you have in India Durga Puja or Kali Mai ki Puja. They go out in the field to make that worship. So the whole city was now empty. And Ibrahim said, well, I am not feeling well, I am not going with you. When the whole town was empty, then he entered the, there, you know, worshipping place where the idols were placed, and he broke all of them except one. So he said, Tallahi, by God, by Allah, I will certainly devise some plot against your idols after you have gone away, turning your backs. فَجَعَلَهُمْ جُزَازًا. So he broke them into pieces, fragments. إِلَّا كَبِيرًا لَهُمْ. Except the biggest idol. لَعَلَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that they should refer to him. Ask him, who has done this? قَالُوا. When they came back and they were startled, what has happened? Just imagine if such an event takes place in the city of Mathura or the city of Banaras in India, what would happen? قَالُوا مَنْ فَعَلَ هَذَا بِعَالِهَتِنَا. Who is the one who has done this to our Lord, our gods? إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily, he is a very big culprit. He is an evil doer. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا فَتَنْ يَذْكُرُهُمْ. Some people said, we heard a youth. He used to mention them. يُقَالُ لَهُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. And his name is Ibrahim. He is called Ibrahim. He did use to mention them. قَالُوا فَاتُوا بِهِ عَلَىٰ عَيُّنِ النَّاسِ. They said, okay, bring him forth before the eyes of the people. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْهَدُونَ So that they also bear witness. قَالُوا أَنْتَ فَعَلْتَ هَذَا بِعَالِهَتِنَا Ya Ibrahim. And now they asked, before that mob is there alone. The mob is there. And how angry that mob would have been, we can imagine. قَالُوا أَنْتَ فَعَلْتَ هَذَا بِعَالِهَتِنَا Ya Ibrahim, oh Ibrahim, have you done this to our gods, our idols? قَالَ بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ هَذَا فَسَلُوهُمْ إِنْ كَانُوا يَنْتِقُونَ He said, this bigger one must have done this. He is safe. All the other are broken. So you ask him. He is a witness. He must have seen who has done it. Or might be he has done it. بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ هَذَا فَسَلُوهُمْ إِنْ كَانُوا يَنْتِقُونَ Now if they speak, ask them. فَرَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ Now this is the moment when the truth dawned on them. So they turned to themselves and said, وَقَالُوا إِنَّكُمْ أَنْتُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ The truth of the matter is that actually you are the evildoers. What Ibrahim is saying is correct. They can't speak. They can't move. This bigger idol could not have broken all these smaller idols. Impossible. They can't move. They can't talk. And this one cannot tell us who did it. And then we worship him. Then. So the truth dawned on them. But then, summa nukisu ala kulubihim. But then they were made to hang their heads down, saying, لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا هَوْلَا يَنْتَقُورُ Oh, Ibrahim, you know, these idols, they can't speak. قَالَ فَتَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكُمْ شَئِنْ وَلَا يَدُرُّكُمْ He said, then you worship besides Allah. These things, who can neither give you any profits, nor they can do you any harm. أُفِّلْ لَكُمْ How disgusting, how disgusting. أُفِّلْ لَكُمْ وَلِمَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ And these whom you are worshipping besides Allah, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ So don't you ponder? Don't you think about it? Don't you understand? قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ They decided and said, Now burn him. وَانْصُرُوا عَلِهَتَكُمْ And help your gods. Because he has done this insult to the gods. So now he must be burned alive. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ If you are going to do something. But when he was thrown in the fire, قُلْنَا We said to the fire, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا لَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمُ O fire, be you a coolness and safety for Ibrahim. Because fire is under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So any command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fire or water or air, these elements of nature have to obey. وَعَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَخْسَرِينَ They had devised a plot against him, but they were the worst losers. Why? Actually, they thought that when Ibrahim will be presented and there will be fire, you know, big, and when he will come to understand that he has been going, he would be thrown, then he will come to his senses and he will apologize and he will turn back to the beliefs of the community. But Ibrahim, you know, he persevered, although he was thrown. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَلُوتًا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ But then Ibrahim made hijrah. He migrated from this country. Actually, he was born in Iraq, in Ur. But now when the nation, you know, they actually put him in the fire to burn him. Now we had to make hijrah from there. This is the rule with the messengers of Allah. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ And we rescued him, Ibrahim, وَلُوتًا And his nephew, Lut, إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ Towards the land which we have blessed for the people of the world. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ نَافِلَةً And then we bestowed upon him a son, Ishaq alayhi salatu wasalam, wa Yaqub, a grandson, Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, nafilatan, in addition. Wa kullan jalna salihin. And all of them we made very righteous people. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. And we made them the leaders and guiders of humanity, who used to guide people with our command. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ فِعْلَ الْخَيْرَاتِ. And we sent them by revelation the good, how to do the good deeds. وَإِقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ. And establishing of the prayers. وَإِتَاءَ الزَّكَاةِ. And paying of zakah. وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. And they were, yes, they were worshipping us. And they were all obedient to us. وَلُوتًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. In the same way, to Lut also, we gave the judgment and knowledge. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ تَعْمَلُ الْخَبَائِسِ. And we rescued him and delivered him from the city, from the township, whose people indulge in very foul and filthy deeds. Sodomy, you know, that was the bad deed of these people, of the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا صَوْئِنَ قَوْمَ صَوْئِنَ فَاسِقِينَ. Verily they were an evil people, transgressors. وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا. And then we admitted him, Lut, in our mercy. إِنَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Verily, he is from amongst the righteous people. وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلِ. And just mention Nuh, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he had called to us, called upon us, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ. Then we responded. And we answered his call, his prayer. And we delivered him and his family مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ, from the mighty distress. وَنَصَرْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. And we helped him against those people who had belied our revelations. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ صَوْئِنَ. They were also a very wicked people. فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُ مَجْمَعِينَ. So we drowned them all together, all of them. فداود وسليمان. And here again is the mention of Dawood and Sulaiman, alayhim as-salatu wasalam. The son and the father. Dawood is the father, Sulaiman is the son. إِذْ يَحْكُمَانِ فِي الْحَرْثِ إِذْ نَفَشَتْ فِيهِ غَنَمُ الْقَوْمِ. When they were judging, you know, a dispute regarding a field, a farm, wherein certain people's sheep strayed, pastured, and destroyed. إِذْ نَفَشَتْ فِيهِ غَنَمُ الْقَوْمِ وَكُنَّا لِحُكْمِهِمْ شَاهِدِينَ. And when they were judging, they were giving their judgment, we were listening, and we were present over there. You know, a person came with a complaint to Dawood alayhi salam. Well, there was a field which I had cultivated, and my, you know, harvest was very, but the sheep and goats of this person, they entered it during the night and destroyed the whole of the field. Now what should I do? How to recompense? What should be the, you know, fine? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave an instantaneous insight to Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. He was young. He said, now this should be done. The flock of these sheep and goats should be given to this person whose field has been destroyed. He should keep them, eat of them, drink their milk. And this field should be again cultivated by the person whose sheep are here. When the field is ready, again harvest is okay, then the field will be given to the owner of the field and the flock of the sheep and goats will go back to the person who owned them. So this judgment was very much liked. فَفَهَمْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَانَ. So we made Sulaiman to understand it. وَكُلَّنْ آتَيْنَا حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. And both of them, Dawood and Sulaiman, to both of them we had given the judgment and knowledge. وَسَخَّرْنَا مَعَ دَاوُودَ الْجِبَالِ. And we had subjected the mountains for Dawood alayhi salam. يُسَبِّحْنَا. To glorify their Lord with him. وَالطَّيْرِ. And not only the mountains, also the birds. وَكُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. And we were the doers. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ صَنَعَةَ لَبُوسٍ لَكُمْ. And we taught him the making of the metal coats for you. لَتُحْسِنَكُمْ مِنْ بَعْسِكُمْ. so as to protect you in your fighting. فَالَنْتُمْ شَاكِرُونَ. So will you then be grateful? وَلَيْ سُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ عَاصِفَةً. And for Sulaiman we subjected the wind blowing strongly. تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. Which blew moving at its command towards the land that we had blessed. وَكُنَّا بِهَا عَالَمِينَ. كُنَّا بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَالَمِينَ. And all the things were in our knowledge. وَمَنَ الشَّيَاطِينَ مَنْ يَغُوسُونَ لَهُ. And subjected, we subjected the satans, the jinns, for him. They used to dive for him in the oceans. وَيَعْمَلُونَ عَمَلًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. And did some other works also beside that. Build very big buildings for him. وَكُنَّا لَهُمْ حَافِظِينَ. And we were watching over them. وَأَيُّوبَ. And mention Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam is Nada Rabba, who had become very sick, very sick, very sick. Some skin disease, there were boils over the whole of the body, decaying, putrefied. Then you know there were insects moving in those wounds. So his family, his sons and daughters, they got fed up, left him. In the end, his wife also left him. But then he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he remained, you know, sabir and shakir. Never complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that what you have done to me. Whatever comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay. It's from him, so I accept it. This should be the attitude of a believer. So when he passed this test, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to his prayer and granted him his prayer. وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ. When he called upon his Lord, أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ. Oh my Lord, affliction has touched me. وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And you are the most merciful of all those who have mercy. You have the maximum mercy. It was the appeal. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. So we answered his call. فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ دُرٍ. And we removed the affliction with which he was afflicted. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ. And we gave back him his family. All the family came back then to him. وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. Another family. Might be he had then married again, and he had another family. وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا. This is all as a gesture of our mercy. وَذِكْرَ لِلْعَابِدِينَ. Or this is a admonition for the worshippers. وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِدْرِيسَ وَذَلْكِفْلِ. And Ismail and Idris and Zulkifl, kullum min as-sabirin. They were all perseverant people. Now about Zulkifl, let me tell you that Quran gives this name twice. But rest no knowledge about it, who he was, where he was born, and which family, lineage, whose lineage, was the progeny of Ibrahim, or somebody else, you know nothing from Quran. And we don't have any details in Hadith also. But there is an opinion of some ulama of India that Mahatma Gautama Buddha, Siddhartha Gautama Buddha, was Zulkifli. Because he was born in Kapalvastu. Kapalvastu, that you know state of the Raja of Kapalvastu, he was the son. So Kapal in Arabic becomes Kafl. Pay is not there. P or pay is not there. It turns into F or Fa. So Zulkafl, the person from Kapal Vastu. And it is just possible. It's just possible, but we can't be sure about it. Kullu min as-sabirin. All of them were from the persevering people. وَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا. And we admitted them and made them enter our mercy. إِنَّهُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Definitely they were from the righteous. وَظَنُّونَ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. And the man of the fish, he is Jonah or Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. He left his nation before the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a messenger is sent to some land or some people or some community, and the community has rejected him, But he cannot leave the community or that place without the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is stationed there, he is deputed there, he is appointed there as messenger of Allah, a representative of Allah. But you know, he got so much fed up with the people and their arrogance that he left without the permission of Allah. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished him. He was swallowed by a big fish, maybe some whale. For some time he remained in the stomach of that whale, but then this whale, you know, vomited him out on the shore, and then you know, he recovered, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repenting and his tawbah and his apologies. وَظَنُّونَ الزَّهَبَ مُغَازِبًا. And ذَنُّون, نُون means fish. ذُنُّون, the man of fish. Recall when he went away enraged. And he thought, فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. And he thought, we could not have any power over him. فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. But then he had to call upon us in the darkness of the stomach of that fish, that whale. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. There's no God except you, O Lord, O Allah. Glory be to you. Inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. I accept that I was the evil doer. I have committed a mistake. I did wrong. I was wrong in leaving my nation without your express permission. And you may recall that, you know, when the permission was given to the companions by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to migrate to Medina, he himself kept back at Makkah, waiting for the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala used to ask him, O Messenger of Allah, has the permission come? No. Has the permission come? No. Because he was preparing two camels, feeding them and making them strong, so that we have to rush then from Makkah to Medina. So all preparation was done by Abu Bakr. But he kept on asking, has the permission come? And the Prophet said, no. Suddenly then, at noon, you know, it's very strange in the Arabian society, nobody visits others' house at noon, because they have that talula, they sleep during the noon. But at the noon, high noon, the Prophet came to the house of Hazrat Abu Bakr and told him that the permission has come. And then they started their journey. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. So we answered the prayer of Yunus alayhi salam also, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمْ. And we delivered him from the grief. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And in this manner, this is our rule, that we deliver the believers. But Zakariya, and just mentioned Zakariya alayhi salatu wassalam, his story we have just read in Surah Maryam. That was a full section. Here is only two ayat. But Zakariya is nada rabbahu, when he called upon his Lord, Rabbi la tadarni fardan. Oh my Lord, don't leave me alone without a son. Alone. If I die, my name is gone. My dynasty finished. And who will look after the mission of the prophetic mission that you have entrusted to me? Who will take it over? لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. You are the best inheritor, okay? If I don't have an inheritor, you are the best inheritor. I accept. But it would be better if you give me a son. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. So we answered his prayer also. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَا. And we bestowed upon him a son, Yahya. وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. And we cured for him his wife, who had been barren up till that time. But now she conceived and she bore a son. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. These people, this family as a whole, they were the people who were competing each other in good deeds. Everyone wanted to go forward, more forward. And this is a society of the believers. Each one of them wants to do more good. Not competing in the worldly things. Well, if he has a big house, I should have a bigger one. No, no, no. The competition is in good deeds, in the service to Allah, in the service for His deen. Who goes more? Who does more? So that was يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَحْبًا. And they used to call upon us, make dua to us, and in both ways. رَغَبًا, having, you know, that we should give them mercy, وَرَحْبًا, and fearing us also. So this calling upon Allah should have both these things. You should have fear also and hope also. Hope of His forgiveness, fear of His punishment. وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ, and they were very humble before us. وَالَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَقْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ رُوحِنَا. And now the last mention is of Maryam, salamu alayha. And that girl or woman who had guarded her chastity fully, then we blew in her from our own spirit. وَجَعَلْنَاهَا بْنَاهَا وَابْنَهَا آيَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And we made her and her son signs for the worlds. إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Now as if Allah is addressing these people, Ibrahim, Nuh, Lut, and Yunus, and all these people, the messengers and prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةٌ وَاحِدَةً. O prophets and messengers, this is the community of yours, and it is one community. We have made communities separate. This is the community or ummah of Musa. This is the community or ummah of Isa. This is the community and ummah of such and such Nabi. No. It's all one. You are all one. They were all servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They all believed in one God. They were all sent by the same Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahida. This community of yours is one community. Wa ana rabbukum fa'budun. And I am your Lord, so continue worshipping me. Wa taqatta'u amrahum bainahum kullun ilayna raji'un. But then they split up their affairs among them, and they all will return to us. After these people passed away, now there were the sects. They are the Jews, they are the Christians, and these are such, and these are such. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Now what is the rule with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Whosoever does good deeds, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And the condition is that he should be a believer. فَلَا كُفْرَانَ لِسَعْيِهِ. So his striving for good deeds will not be rejected or disapproved. وَإِنَّا لَهُ كَاتِبُونَ. And we are writing and recording all the good deeds they are doing. وَحَرَامٌ عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا أَنَّهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ. And it is forbidden for the people of a city which is going to be destroyed, for which Allah's command is destruction, the final chastisement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now it is forbidden for the people, they can't return. It can have two meanings. They can't repent. They can't go to Allah's, you know, call and accept it. Because now the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already come. خَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ. Now they cannot come back. Secondly, once destroyed and gone from this world, they cannot return to this world. They are gone, gone by the wind. They cannot come back. حَتَّى إِذَا فُتِحَتْ يَعْجُوجُ وَمَعْجُوجُ. This thing with the communities will continue happening till such time that the Gog and Magog are opened, let loose. وَهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ حَدَبٍ يَنْسِلُونَ. And you will see them. They will be coming down from every mound. Now who are these Gog and Magog? It's a controversial issue. One thing is sure. Gog and Magog are among the names of the sons of the third son of Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam had three sons, Sam, Ham, Yafis. The progeny of Sam settled, because you know, where did Nuh live? The area which we call today Kurdistan. This is a place where three, four countries meet together. north of Iraq, northwest of Iran, east of Turkey and Syria, and then Russia or the USSR, the Caucasia. These countries merge here, and this was the place abode of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam and his people. And there is that hillock, you know, where the ark came to stay after the flood was gone. Now from there, you know, these three sons, when they came out from the ark, so Sam descended southward, Iraq, Sham, and the Arabian Peninsula. These nations were called the Semitic nations. Ibrahim was Semitic, he was from Iraq. Syrians, Semitic. Arabians, Semitic. Muhammad is Semitic, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the prophets of the Old Testament, they are all progeny of Ibrahim, they are Semitics. Number two, Ham. The progeny of Ham spread to the east and to the west, not downward, not to the south. Iran and India. And on the other side, Egypt and Sudan, and some East European countries. This is the progeny of Hazrat Ham. But the progeny of Hazrat Yafis, that crossed over the mountains of Central Asia, and then they spread to the east and west. So China, Mongolia, Russia, because among their sons is Tobal and Mosk. One name is Mosk. Maybe Moscow might have been, you know, founded by that son of Yafis. So these are the nations of Gog and Magog. And they were the people to, for them, you know, that wall was erected by, as we had read in Surah Al-Kahf, by Dhul-Qarnayn, between the Caspian Sea and the Black Sea. This is, you know, a very broad pass through which these people used to come and plunder the nations which were settled in the plains in the, to the south. But then he erected the wall over there and stopped so that they couldn't come and invade. So these are Gog and Magog. And it is in the Ahadith also, in many details, that near the end of this world, near Qiyamah, these nations will be let loose. They will bring havoc to this globe, destruction and havoc. And their final confrontation would be with Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And even Hazrat Isa would have to withdraw from them to the mountains. They will be so formidable force, you know. They will drink all the water of the sea. Sea of Galilee will go dry because they will drink each and every drop of it. Now this sea, which Quran says, min kulli hadabi yansalun, you will see these nations coming down, sliding down from all the slopes. This scene has once happened in history in 1962, when there was a war between India and China. And you know, the reports in the newspapers were, waves after waves of the Chinese soldiers were descending from the mountains, and what humiliation had, you know, India had to face at that time. A very big defeat, very shameful defeat at the hands of the, because in numbers they are very great. Chinese. And all this area, you know. So they are from the Gog and Magog. And they are all the progeny of Hazrat Yafis alayhi salatu wasalam. Hatta idha futihat yajuj wa majuj. Now this means, when that hour will come near of Qiyamah or Asa'ah, and these Yajuj and Majuj will be let loose. And you will see them coming down from all the slopes. Maybe the slopes of the mountains of the Central Asia also. And slopes of Himalayas, just as it was in the Nifa in 1962. Slopes of Himalayas, and they are coming down. Waves and waves of Chinese soldiers coming. You kill one, the other wave is coming. You murder all of them, the third wave is coming. So waves after waves of Chinese soldiers were coming down the slopes of the Himalayas. وَاقْتَرَبَ الْوَعْدُ الْحَقُّ. And at that time, the promise, time of that promise would come near. وَعْدُ الْحَقُّ. But that is of the hour, the doomsday, the day of resurrection. فَإِذَا هِيَ شَاخِصَةُ الْأَبْصَارُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And you will find that at that time, that the eyes of the disbelievers would be staring in terror. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا They will say, woe to us, قَدْ كُنَّا فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا We were heedless of this. We were never thought seriously that this can come to happen. The messengers of Allah foretold, but we never believed in them. بَلْ كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ We were actually the evil doers. إِنَّكُمْ وَمَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ حَسَمُ جَهَنَّمُ But now, no use. Now you have to be. Now only, not only you, but those whom you have been worshipping, your idols, they will all be thrown in the fire of hell and they will become, you know, a sort of wood. حَسَمُ جَهَنَّمُ There they will be burnt away. لَوْ قَالَ هَاُ لَا عَلِهَةً At that time they will think that if these idols were gods, مَا وَرَدُوهَا They should not have come to this fire of hell. وَكُلٌ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ But all of them will have to live there forever, for eternity. لَهُمْ فِيهَا زَفِيرٌ وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يَسْمَعُونَ They will be sighing there with deep sorrow and grief. But they will be able to listen nothing. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى On the contrary, verily those for whom a good word has already passed from us, ordained, we have ordained already. أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبْعَدُونَ They will kept away from this Jahannam, this hell. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسًا They will not have to hear only even its whisper. وَهُمْ فِي بَشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ And they will abide forever in those things which their souls desire. لَا يَحْزَنُهُمُ الْفَضُلُ الْأَكْبَرُ This great terror shall not grieve them of Zalzala. Zalzala Tussara. The next surah is going to begin very soon. And the first word is, إِنَّ زَلْزَلَ تَسَّعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ The earthquake at the time of the doomsday would be a very great event. But these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will save them. The great terror shall not grieve them. لَا يَحْزَنُهُمُ الْفَضَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ And Malaika, the angels will come and greet them. هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ Now this day has come, which was promised to you. That is, now you will enter paradise. يَوْمَ نَتْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَتَيِّ السِّجِلَّ لِلْكُتُبِ Just imagine the day, the doomsday, when we shall roll up all the heavens, just as the rolling of a scroll for writing. You know, in the ancient days, books were not bound like this. They used to be in scrolls. One paper you have written, now paste another one, and you just roll it. And now second you are rolling. Rolling and rolling on, writing and rolling. So these are called the scrolls. Now today we don't have scrolls, we have books, bound books, leaves and bound books. But the simile here is, يَوْمَ نَتْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَتَيِّ السِّجِلَّ لِلْكُتُبِ The day when we shall roll up heaven like the rolling up of a scroll for writing. كَمَا بَدَانَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِدَهُ As we had originated them in the first creation, we shall restore it. وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا This is a promise binding on us. إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ And we shall definitely do it. Now here we can understand there is the theory of expanding universe. The universe is expanding. Expanding, 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 going on. But then there is a theory that time will come when expansion will start. And inward rolling, reverse rolling will start. And that inverse rolling might be the whole universe again comes to one spot. Just as the galaxies have come to one holes, which we call the black holes, you know, in the space, black holes. There used to be some very big galaxy over here. It collapsed, and now there's only a hole. Very dreadly hole. Everything passing by that goes there and vanishes. So in the same way, this whole universe might become again, you know, it started from one point, the Big Bang. And Big Bang, it started expanding and expanding and expanding. But a time will come when it will roll back and it will again come to the starting point. كَمَا بَدَانَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِدُهُ As we had originated them in the first creation, we shall make them return to the same. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزُّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الزِّكْرِ And we had written it down in Zabur, in Psalms, after the admonition, أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِسُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ That the earth will inherit the land by righteous servants will inherit the land, the earth. Now it can have two means. Meanings, number one, that the earth here, the land here, which is mentioned is the land of paradise. The land of paradise will be inherited by people who have done good deeds, the believers. Another thing can mean that before the end of this world, a time will come that the whole this world will be ruled by the people who are righteous, who are servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to this effect, we have a clear prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That before the end of this world, Islam will dominate the whole of the globe. لا يبقى على ظهر الأرض بيت وبر ولا بدر إلا أدخله الله كلمة الإسلام. The hadith in Musnad Ahmed ibn Hanbal from Miqdad ibn Aswad radiallahu anhu that not a single house will remain made of bricks and clay and not a single tent will remain of the nomads in which Allah will not make the deen of Allah, Islam, enter. This will happen. So a global domination of the deen of Allah. This is Khilafah ala minhajin nabuwah. And the Prophet has said, this period will come again. The Khilafah ala minhajin nabuwah, just after the death of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was the Khilafah Rashida, we know it. The caliphate, pious caliphate. The same system will again be established on this earth. So that this ayah can mean that also. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الزِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِسُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ We had already written in Zabur, in Psalms, after the admonition, that this land will be inherited by our righteous servants. Either before the end of this world, there is a global domination of the Muslim Ummah and Islam established as a deen, as a social order over the whole of the world. Or after the end of this world, the land of paradise will be inherited by our righteous servants. Inna fi hadha la balaghan li qaumin abidin. And in this is surely a message for the worshippers who worship us. Wama arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alameen. And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, but a mercy for all the nations of the world. This is again a hint. Because if he has been sent for the whole of the world, now his deen, which he brought with him, must be dominant over the whole of the world. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. He was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this deen of haq in order to make it supreme. So when he has been sent for the whole of humanity, and for all the world, so then the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is deenul haq, that is deenullah. Deenullah and deenul Muhammad the same. That will dominate the whole of the globe. قُلْ إِنَّمَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is being revealed to me, this wahi has come to me, that your Lord is only one God. فَعَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ So do you surrender yourself to him or not? فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا If they turn their faces, فَقُلْ أَعْذَنْتُكُمْ عَلَىٰ سَوَىٰ So proclaim that I have conveyed to you the message alike, all alike. I have spoken to the rich, to the poor. I have spoken to the high, to the low. I have preached in your streets. I have knocked at your doors. I have talked to you in privately. I have addressed you in public. I have done whatever I could do. آذنتكم على سواء وَإِنْ أَدْرِيَ قَرِيبٌ بَعِيدٌ مَا تُوعَدُونَ Now this I don't know. Whether the chastisement that is promised to you has come near or it is a bit far off. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a further respite. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe that chastisement has come to your doorsteps. I don't know. This knowledge is with Allah. إِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْجَهْرَ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ He, Allah, knows whatever is spoken aloud وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْتُمُونَ And he knows what you conceal in your hearts. He knows everything. وَإِنْ أَدْرِي لَعَلَّهُ فَيَطْمِطُ لَكُمْ And I don't know, I can't say. Maybe it is going to be another test for you. وَمَتَعُوا لِلَاحِينَ Or maybe an enjoyment, a respite for some time. قَالَ رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ And finally the Prophet, now he is calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ Oh my Lord, now give the judgment, final judgment with truth. These words depict the psychological position of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was also now fed up. I have taken much pains. I have spent 10, 11 years in a small city. And I have been preaching here for 10, 11, 12 long years. So now, oh Lord, your judgment should come. قَالَ رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ Oh my Lord, now give the final judgment with truth. رَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ And our Lord is Rahman, the compassionate one. And only His help can be sought on those things which you are describing about Him.